Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Nirmala Roy from SBS Medical College, Jaipur, Rajasthan. I thank you, CT Buzz, for giving this opportunity to present my paper. The topic is incremental role of high-pitched prospective computer tomography in evaluation of pediatric congenital heart diseases and associated abnormalities. The prevalence of congenital heart diseases varies from 6 to 10 per 1,000 live births in India. Echocardiography is initial imaging modality for assessment of and diagnosis of CHDs. Three-dimensional imaging is particularly useful in diagnostic investigation of complex congenital heart disease and preparation of complex interventional procedures and post-operative assessment of surgical reconstruction. MDCT has faster acquisition and high spatial resolution. It can show morphology of extracardiac vasculature. National program, Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram, also aims at early detection and early intervention of CHDs. The aim of my study was to identify role of prospective ECG-gated computer tomography in diagnosing CHDs with objectives to assess and compare accuracy of CT and transthoracic echocardiography in diagnosis of congenital heart diseases and determine sensitivity of CT in diagnosing intracardiac malformation and extracardiac great vessel malformations. It was a prospective type of descriptive study. The tools we used were chest X-ray, echo, and prospective ECG-gated cardiac CT. The sample size was of 30 patients of suspected CHD. It was a 5-month duration study. Inclusion criteria remained the patients of suspected CHD as diagnosed on echo, and 20 patients were included in the study. The exclusion criteria was raised serum creatinine, hemodynamically unstable children, and patients with known allergy to IV contrast media. CT protocol was non-contrast. Ionic agent was injected in peripheral vein at a dose of 1 to 2 ml per kg and at a flow rate of 2 to 3 ml per second, followed by saline bolus. The results were age distribution: 8 patients fall in age group 1 to 6 months of age, followed by 6 patients in 6 months to 1 year. Major anomalies we encountered were TA PVC in 5 patients, out of which 3 had situs ambiguous. TOF patients were 6, truncus arterios 1 patient, CCTGA 1 patient, DTGA 2 patients, double outlet right ventricle 2 patients, double outlet left ventricle 1 patient, coarctation aorta 2 patients, and 5 patients had PDA. 16 patients presented with apparent cyanosis. Out of 20 patients, 13 were male and 7 were female. 2 patients had right isomerism, and 1 patient was each of situs inversus and left isomerism. 16 had normal situs solitus. In cardiac situs, 16 patients were levocardia and 4 patients were dextrocardia. Systemic vein variations: 2 patients had double SVC and 1 had left SVC. 17 were normal. In pulmonary vein, 4 patients had TA PVC and 1 patient PA PVC. In pulmonary artery anomalies, 2 had dilated pulmonary arteries and 9 had atretic or infundibular pulmonary stenosis. In aortic arch, 3 patients had right-sided mirror branching, 2 patients had coarctation of aorta, and 1 patient each was of left-sided aortic arch with aberrant right subclavian artery and right-sided aortic arch with aberrant left subclavian artery, and 14 had normal. 2 had coronary artery variations, 6 patients had MAPCAS, and 5 patients were of PDAs. Summary: study included 20 patients with congenital heart diseases of both sexes. Chest X-ray and echo of each patient were noted for comparison. In our study, maximum number of patients were male, 13 out of 20, and 8 out of 20 were in age group 1 to 6 months. Most cases presented with clinically apparent cyanosis. Most common symptoms were frequent lung infections in infants and later failure to thrive and respiratory distress on exertion. Comparison between echo and cardiac CT: cardiac CT was superior to echo in diagnosing situs, cardiac situs, systemic vein, pulmonary artery, aorta, coronaries, MAPCAS, and PDAs. Cardiac CT was as good as echo in diagnosing VLG, atria, ventricles and atrioventricular connections and ventriculo-arterial connections. Echo was superior in diagnosing cardiac CT in ASD. Cases: male child presented with sandroid spell and dyspnea. We can see right ventricular volume overload and D-shaped IV septum and right atrium dilated. Membranous VSD, aorta overriding, narrow right and left pulmonary artery, and infundibular pulmonary stenosis. So this was a classical case of tetralogy of Fallot. 4-month-old female child presented with pneumonitis, ASD, common AV canal, pulmonary artery, pulmonary veins draining into left atrium, then RVOT and LVOT from the left ventricle, and left persistent SVC. So this was a case of double outer left ventricle and double SVC. Again, this is a case in which we found coarctation of aorta preductal and relative narrowing of RPA. Then there was a progressive decreasing diameter of descending aorta. Then tubular shaped PDA can be seen. And in lower lung fields, we can see ground classing and consolidation. So this was a case of preductal coarctation of aorta PDA and suspicion of mid-aortic syndrome. 18-month-old female child present with recurrent respiratory infections. We can see large inlet VSD, infundibular pulmonary stenosis, and RVOT and LVOT having origin from the right ventricle. Then we can see a small LPA and PDA. and dilated aortic annulus. Then this is the PDA. And there were multiple MAP cars. So this was a case of DORV, PDA, and major mediastinal aortopulmonary collaterals. 3-month old boy, pulmonary veins were prominent. Then there was a common origin of aorta and pulmonary artery truncus. Then a right-sided aortic arch with aberrant left subclavian artery, which traverses behind the esophagus. Common origin of both the carotid arteries and aberrant left subclavian artery. Truncus arch. So this was a case of truncus arteriosus and right-sided aortic arch with ALSCA. 1-month old female, common single atrium. Then common atrioventricular defect with associated VSD. Then this is the pulmonary atresia and origin of aorta from the morphological right ventricle anterior to the pulmonary artery. So this was a case of DTG, dextrocardia, and complete AV canal defect. Then a male child presented with sinusitis, pulmonary veins draining into left atrium, which was opening into morphological right ventricle. Pulmonary artery arising from the morphological left ventricle and overrides the VSD. Then aorta originates from the morphological right ventricle and it is anterior and superior to anterior and left to the pulmonary artery and large membranous VSD. So this was a case of congenitally corrected TGA. 2-month-old male child, X-ray we can see dextrocardia and midline liver and bilateral trifurcated epiarterial bronchi, right-sided aortic arch. Then pulmonary veins formed a venous channel and drained into the portal vein. Then dextrocardia and AV septal defect and complete absence of pulmonary arteries. So this was a case of right-sided isomalism with AV septal defect. 4-year-old girl child with poor growth. On echo, we could see a left-sided cardiac apex and large VSD in common AV canal. Then both lobes, bilobe lungs and bilateral bifurcated hyperarterial bronchi. Interruption or interrupted IVC with azygous continuation into right-sided SVC. Anterior facing sinus gave the origin to RCA and LCX originated from the RCA and posterior facing sinus gave the origin to LMCA. Then left-sided liver and right-sided spleen and all the hepatic veins directly draining. Then the pulmonary veins drained into a proximal chamber, which was separated by a fibromuscular band. This was a classical cord triatrium. Then common AV canal and VSD and interrupted IVC and hypoplastic pulmonary artery. So this was a case of left-sided isomerism with other associated findings. And again, a 10-year-old female child with respiratory distress, we could see a thrombus in LPA. Then pulmonary atresia with PDA. It is a volume image of this case. And posterior facing sinus gave origin to the single coronary from which the LMCA originated, giving rise to LMCA, RCA originated from the LMCA and this volume rendition image. Then spleen on the right side and left side liver and left LVC and SVC and IVC draining into left sided atrium. So this was a case of situs inversus with other associated findings. So conclusion, congenital heart disease are fairly common in India. Maximum number of cases presents below 1 year of age. X-ray and echocardiography are good initial screening modalities. Cardiac CT angiography provides detail of pulmonary artery and its branches, presence and absence of major aortopulmonary collateral arteries, coronary artery anomalies, aortic arch anomalies, additional findings in of the lung parenchyma bony cage. Cardiac CT angiography is useful in alternative to cardiac catheter angiography, especially in pediatrics, due to its non-invasiveness, high sensitivity and specificity. It gives accurate and important information to treating cardiovascular surgeon to plan surgery accordingly. Thank you. These are my references.